Everybody, and welcome once again to YouTube Channel Review Live. By the way, my name is Pedro Bulianes. Do you know that you have a purpose? In this channel, we declare I have a purpose. Thank you for all of you who have subscribed to my YouTube channel. For those of you who haven't yet subscribed, please click on the subscribe button and hit the notification bell for you to be updated with our new video. So I'm so excited because you could also like be a part of my channel by joining to become a member, and you will have perks from it. Just click the join button and you would have it. But I'm really blessed this very day to have a special guest for everybody. Like you all know, we have YouTube content creators from around the world, from India, from Pakistan, from Egypt, from Uganda. Yesterday, we have somebody from Nigeria, from Indonesia, from the States, from America, and also from Australia. But this very day is very special because we have, this is the first motivational YouTube content creator from the States or from America that we will feature. So I will give this time right now for Sunshine Ray to introduce herself and introduce what her channel is all about. So take it away, Sunshine.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for having me, Pedro. I really appreciate it. I wanted to do something ministry related, and being able to touch people, especially in this coronavirus time, it's more difficult to reach out to people in person. So of course, YouTube is a wonderful opportunity to be able to talk out. My sons actually wanted to do a YouTube channel first, and so since they were doing it and I was already kind of learning about it, I decided to join them in their venture. And also my daughter was joining me as well. In fact, she's going to get back to homework, but she wants to say hi real quick. Want to say hi?
Hi, everyone.
All right. Sweetheart, you may go back. So we do scripture readings and music. I am a massage therapist, so in kind of the business of relaxation. So that's why we have music and the calming sounds as well.
All right, so there you have it. And thank you very much, Sunshine, for being there. I know this is really a great time for people to know more about you and your channel. So everybody, I know this is, she's, you could see there in my screen. Sunshine, could you see my screen, share?
Yes.
Okay, so for everyone who's watching right now and who's going to be watching this video, maybe on rebroadcast, I really want you to go now to any of your gadgets, iPhone, iPad, any Android device or your laptop or anything that you're using for internet, go to www.youtube.com and I want you to type in the search Sunshine, S-U-N-S-H-I-N-E space Ray, R-A-E space of O-N-F space random, R-A-N-D-O-M. And you have to log into your Gmail account and just click the subscribe button there, the red one. Not just that, click the bell and click all. Again, go to youtube.com and then type Sunshine, S-U-N-S-H-I-N-E space Ray, R-A-E space of O-N-F space random, R-A-N-D-O-M. And then just click the subscribe button, click the bell, and click all. All right. I'm so into like knowing more about your channel, Sunshine here. So could you tell us like the history, or how did Sunshine Ray of Random Channel came to existence? Because I know everybody has their own history and how their channel started. So how did this channel, how did it start, and what was the vision behind it?
Well, because I actually have done ministry for several years now, actually was part of a musical ministry group and had opportunities to travel in South America and US and even Egypt or Korea and some other places. And since coming back home and becoming a mom, actually a mom of four children, and that has been the focus for a while. And so being able to have an opportunity to minister in a way that was manageable with having, you know, four kids and a massage therapy business, this was an opportunity. When my sons wanted to start their gaming channel, that I started one also with my daughter. And I also would like to sing at some point on the channel. I'm still trying to figure out copyright rules and things like that, because that's usually what I've done for ministry in the past, but decided to do some scripture reading. I know there are other audio Bibles out there, but because sometimes I have a hard time understanding words that are not spoken very clearly, I wanted to do something that I really enunciated and tried to make sure that people could understand the words, and also enjoy having some scenery and maybe some music in the background of those scriptures as well, was kind of the original. And also the name, Sunshine Ray of Random, the Ray part is part of family name background. Sunshine is a nickname of my daughter that you just met, and of Random is because we enjoy such a variety of things that even though focus would be ministry, sometimes we put some random videos on there, like we made some banana bread together and my daughter was squishing it up and some unboxing and stuff like that. And so we've only been around for 2 months now, so we hope to do more of all the above.
Wow, that's really great to know, like, your passion for passion for the ministry, and even if you have your family right now and four kids. Wow, being a mom, being a wife, having four kids, and still just giving time for this opportunity, especially in this times right now, to share the word of God. That's really great. And yeah, I'm so excited also, like you mentioned, like, your kids are also doing a gaming channel, and then you and your daughter are also involved in YouTube. So I'm assuming that your family really is supporting you with making this channel. Is that correct?
Yes. It's very much a family event. Very much a family event. In fact, one of our videos, I think, has pretty much all of us in it.
Wow. That's really great. So, all right, so Sunshine, I've got a question for you, if it's okay. So now people are also maybe like you, there are moms, also a wife, also have children, and they also wanted to start their YouTube channel, okay? So what could you suggest to them in starting their, especially like motivational, if they also are into motivational stuff, like you are, and sharing the word or sharing your family? So what could you advise for them to do in starting their channel?
The biggest thing is sometimes I have had this attitude that something has to be perfect. And I really just had to say, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. God can use me as I am. It isn't always called a qualified, but he can qualify the called. And to not look for perfection. Yes, do my best with, you know, a sound or a microphone or, you know, whatever it is that you may or may not have, but don't overanalyze it and don't wait till, you know, sometimes you can edit it till the cows come home and you over try to do it. Sometimes you just have to go for it and, you know, share and even, you know, doing this and just do your best with it.
Yeah, I really like what you said there. God didn't call the qualified, but he qualifies those who are called. Wow. Preach it, Sunshine. You know, it's really great to hear your story about that. So going to your channel, we'll be going there. I will be sharing my screen, although you're sharing yours there, but it's just okay. We could go here now on your first ever video, all right? Sunshine, we will be checking it. I'm so excited with this one. All right, here we go. Date added oldness. All right, this is your first ever video. Wow, it was just 2 months ago, and it's already had 558 views. Could you say something about this video? How did you prepare for this? What's going on in your mind when you made this, or anything?
Well, it's about the grace of God, and the scriptures appear on the screen, and I love beautiful music because being a singer and just how it sounds and so relaxing. And as far as the scriptures, that's what I live by, is I can only be here by the grace of God, and it's only by his grace that I'm saved. And so just being able to share that initially with people, so they kind of had a summary, being a first video, of kind of what I stood for. And I love this verse from Lamentations that talks about we are not consumed because of his mercies, and that his mercies are new every morning. And just being able to share that. And of course, you know, it was a new thing for me. So just trying to get my feet wet, and how, you know, getting the font on there and knowing how to get copyright, or excuse me, how to get like pictures that I could legally use, and, you know, things like that.
Wow. Wow. That's really great. And yeah, this is really awesome here. And I'm just going to play it there on the screen. But so, because here's the question, Sunshine Ray, and I know maybe if you're watching this video and you have the same heart like Sunshine Ray of Random Channel here, and you wanted to share, but you, all right, so people now, Sunshine Ray of Random Channel here, they really want Sunshine, like, to just really start their channel, because they're really motivated by you here. So what could you advise them in making their first video? Because the hardest part in YouTube, honestly, is making your first video. So what could you advise for them to make, on how they could make their first motivational video?
Really just going for it, because like I was talking about before, about not, obviously you want to do your best, but not to put yourself in such a realm of perfection that you're not doing anything. Sometimes you feel like you have to get everything so ready that you never start. So really just taking that first step forward. I gather my strength by my faith in Jesus Christ. So really just asking his direction. And even in some of my other videos, I ask, Lord, what do you want me to share? What do you want to talk about? And that's been Romans and Psalms so far, but it could change in the future. And just learning, like YouTube is a great resource, obviously, learning, okay, how do you set up a channel? Okay, how do you make a thumbnail? How do you upload? How do you edit a video once it's already been posted? You know, just all these little things. And whether your resource is YouTube or blogs or whatever, it just learning and soaking it up, and then not feeling like you have to learn everything before you start, because I'm still learning, obviously.
Wow. So how did you feel when you've seen your video right now? It's already 558 views. Wow, this is really great. So could you tell us something about that?
I was a little surprised. I didn't have too many expectations, because, you know, there's obviously a lot of content on YouTube. So you don't always know what may or may not touch somebody. And so sometimes it's really special, you know, reading some of the comments and seeing how people can be affected. And obviously I don't take the glory. It's God's word, and God's word stands on its own, and God's word is powerful on its own. So I really appreciate that he can use me in that way. He meaning God.
Wow. Look at that. Women are just really commenting here, people. Wow. Wow. This is great. Lots of comments for this video. Really great. All right. So my next question is, what's the vision or what's the big dream for this channel, like Sanctuary of Random, and what's the next, what are your next steps, or like what do you plan to do like for this next couple of days?
Well, for the immediate family goals is getting through some homework. But for the channel, it's trying to, I kind of am trying to formulate what is the best plan as far as to get the all that I would love to accomplish done, because you have a few things going on. So I'd like to, you know, do more scriptures, more relaxing music, more calming sounds. But also, we do have one video right here of a mini audio drama, and that's the one I was talking about, had the whole family, and it's only 4 minutes. But when I was young, and even sometimes now, there's actually a Christian drama series called Adventures of Odyssey, and I grew up loving that. And so we thought it fun to just make our own little one. And my two sons that are doing the gaming channel, they kind of fight at the beginning of the episode. And then the story in First Kings about the wisdom of King Solomon, where he talks about, you know, bring me a sword in order, and shows, displays King Solomon's wisdom. So we would love to do a little bit more audio dramas that include current day situations, but also utilize the scripture in knowing what we're actually learning in that sense. And most of the visual of that particular video is just listening, but it seemed to have a good response. And people that even know me on Facebook and stuff had asked, do more like this, do more like this. So that was some feedback. And also, I would love to do singing in, and like I was saying earlier, just trying to figure out some copyright stuff and how to utilize that and regarding music and lyrics, but we'll get there with God's help and grace.
Wow. Yeah. I'm really seeing here, like, you're really crushing even like the comments here, like 132 comments for this video. This is really great. Wow. Like, I was just reading their comments here, and could we hear something about it?
Then, while I was still asleep, she got up and took my son out of my bed.
Wow.
Put him in her bed.
This is really great. Sanctuary, a random channel here. I'm telling everybody, please go now to your YouTube.com, type in Sanctuary, a random. This is really a great channel. It's like bring back childhood memories when we have like books there with Bible stories and stuff like that, and also listening to like audio stuff. Wow, this is great. It reminds me of my childhood too. So it was just 3 weeks ago.
It's a really fun family event.
Yeah.
We really enjoy it as a family.
And knowing that you're doing it as a family, that really means a lot there. So, wow. Wow. This is, I'm so amazed by this. And all right. So let's go.
Random with the banana bread. Oops.
All right. So you had that video too. So could you tell us something about that? Oh, so you're doing that also. Anyway, so let me go back here, and I will just go on through your videos again. This is great. All right. Let's go to your videos. So you have been, wait, sort by, here we go. Wow. 2 months, 2 months, 1 month, 1 month, 6 days ago. You have been very consistent here with your uploading of your videos. And I really commend you for that, right? So the last upload actually here was 2 days ago. So if it's okay for you, Sunshine, to just really talk about how do you make this commitment in being consistent on uploading your channel, despite and in spite that you're a mom, you're a wife at the same time, you have 4 kids, and you're still like having that spa business. I couldn't really imagine how you are doing this, or how do you like put your time on it? How do you manage your time on it? Could you just tell us something about it? Because it's like most people does YouTube and they're like saying, oh no, I couldn't make my new video now. I'm really busy. But here comes you just really having a lot of content. So could you just tell us something about that?
Well, first and foremost, my commitment is to God. Second, to my family. And what's nice about this is because it involves the family, then that can be kind of a combined situation. Like here, my youngest daughter is unboxing an LOL doll. And so we kind of have fun doing that together. And the one that I was telling you about earlier with the audio drama that involved almost everybody. And my husband is in IT, so he kind of helps me if there's any technicalities like internet or so forth like that. A couple of us made the banana bread together, and so we just kind of having fun with it. And I also, to manage the time, I don't always have time to do it all at once. So you just do a piece, like you know, the banana bread. You make the banana bread in one day, and then another day you might edit, and I kind of layer it, meaning you might be releasing a video, but you're still already partially through another video. And because if you complete a video and you don't even start anything until a couple days after that, it's kind of hard to fit in with, you know, managing a family and all of that part of it. Perhaps if somebody had more time, they would be fine to not start a video until after they finish one. But I have to kind of like do pieces. Like on the scripture reading, maybe I would record 2 or 3 segments at once, and then, you know, one time add some music and another time add some font or scenery or whatever. But to do it all at once would probably not be something I'm able to fit in my day-to-day activity. So just doing bite size, you know, do something each day, whether it's maybe replying to some comments or, you know, visualizing what you'd like to do next, or praying, or, you know, talking to the kids about it or whatever, because we're just only, like I said, 2 months old. It's kind of formulating what maybe stands out and what feedback is also. So it's been kind of fun doing that with them.
Yeah. Once again, for those of you who are doing YouTube or are planning to have one, and you think that you have no time to do it, this is my advice for you. Go now to Sunshine Ray of Random. Just pick any of their videos. Just click it. And here's the thing. Comment to any of those videos and ask questions. I know, like, the person behind this channel is really legit. She's really crushing it. She's like making her family get involved. You know, there's really this problem right now in just making your family involved into something that you love. And here comes you making them involved in this, and they're having fun. And not just that, you are in a group with your family, and you inspire more people, you motivate more people. This is really awesome here. More than just the channel, the story behind it, the foundation and the core on this channel. This is really awesome. So with that in mind, Sunshine, could I just ask for you to say something to those people who has a channel, or some of them have already grow a little bit of their channel, but their family is not supporting them? What could you give them as an advice?
Had my family not been supporting me, because my source of strength is Jesus Christ, I would first reach out to him and ask for his will in the situation. I do know, depending on someone's belief, if they are Christian and do believe in God as their source of direction, if they believe that they have been led to do a channel to stay the course, and that his strength will be made perfect in any weakness, and to not give up. I know with limited options, depending what country or city somebody is from, that there hasn't been as many things for families to go and do together. So this was kind of a fun way that we could get out there, you know, as far as being able to share with others, whoever they might be around the world, and do it together, since we can't, you know, maybe go to somewhere local like we would have even just last year. So mostly just giving up and relying on your source of strength. If you don't know Jesus, I would just encourage you to get to know him and to talk to him. He's there waiting for us.
Wow. This is really getting more exciting here. So just to reiterate what Sunshine was telling us here is that we have to know where our strength is coming from. Because if we know the source of strength, then we will be able to accomplish and just really be focused on our commitment in what we are doing and just doing something that is on the will of God is really great to know him. And you have said here, I was taking down some notes here, right? that the strength is made perfect. His strength is made perfect in our weakness. I really love that verse in the Bible. And it's really not saying that we could do everything, but if we acknowledge that we are weak, and that's the moment that we depend not on our own strength, but on the strength of the of God and of the one who is the source of everything. Wow. You know, Sunshine, I will be talking to you maybe later because I have also like a segment in my different channel. It's like a motivational channel. I really wanted to invite you there. And I really wanted to share more about these verses. You know what? All right. I don't want to be carried away with the channel review first. Let's do this. All right. Let's talk about it later. Yeah. I'm so blessed. I'm so, you know, just to be honest with everybody, the reason why I made this channel, Sunshine, the reason why I made this is because I wanted to share my daily devotional. That's just it.
Awesome.
So I started it like 3 years ago. I had like some kind of like thing with my sneakers and stuff. But I said to myself, after 2 years, I wanted to just share my daily devotional. It really went well with my channel too. So yeah, I'm so inspired right now with what you're doing. And I'm like, oh my goodness. All right, let's not go about the deeper stuff with that. Yeah, I'm just reminded by that every time. And that's also like the reason why I'm doing this channel review, just to inspire, motivate people to. Yeah. So going back to your channel, it's really great here. And I could like, we're going to be discussing the technical stuff of this. So is it just okay with you, Sunshine, that we're gonna go there now? Yeah, because like,
would love to learn.
I've got no questions with regards to your channel. It's really great here for now. For anyway, first things first here, your channel art is really great. Okay.
Okay.
But if I may suggest. Mm-hmm. That you could put words on it. That would really mean a lot. Yeah, that's the Sunshine Ray of Random here. And then maybe you could pick a tagline or, like, for example, like your niche. What is it all about? Like, for example, motivation, faith, and anything. Just put it there. I'm going to let you see my channel here. This is really not a great one. But there, I just put it there. Travel, motivation, and business. So it could help them understand what what's the channel they're subscribing. Does that make sense with you,
yeah,
Sunshine?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, and I really wanted to ask, have you heard of Canva.com already?
Yes, that is the free option, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You could do that because everything's free there. And you could also do that with your thumbnails. And even with your videos, they have free photos there wherein you could use. So I know that could really help a lot too. But like this one, the Sunshine at Random, your logo here, this mm-hmm. is really great. Who made this one?
Mostly myself.
Wow, that's really great.
And this is really great. The photography was I was able to use with the license through, I think it was Elements in Tavo, or however you pronounce it.
Wow, that's great. And yeah, the name is also like speaks for itself. But here, let's go to your subscribers. You are just like, let me see that. You just had this channel 2 months ago, and you have 223 subscribers. So what can you feel? What can you say about that? Because not all people have these subscribers. People like 2 years, 3 years still have like 100 plus. How did you go about this? How did this happen here? Could you share a story with your subscribers here?
Mostly community. Whether it's, for me, it was mostly virtually. I was part of a Christian YouTuber group on Facebook. And so, and it's not sub for sub or anything, but people enjoy supporting each other. And so if you're sharing videos and they would care to subscribe, they're welcome to, but nobody is forced or anything like that. And so because they choose to subscribe, they stay subscribed. Obviously there's like a little bit of up and down, which I hear happens with every channel. But not to be discouraged, you know, like I've heard some people go to their subscribers every hour, every day, and like, oh no, I lost one. But sometimes it can just be YouTube cleaning out the, you know, who does or doesn't watch stuff. So I don't worry about that because my goal is to just share about the gospel, and God knows who's going to hear it, and his word will speak for itself. So who am I to decide who should or shouldn't hear it? I'm doing my best as far as being able to, you know, share it and, you know, make community that way. But I, at this point, I actually haven't told a whole lot of people in my person, because sometimes people share with their live family and friends and get discouraged if they're not, you know, subscribing right away. But sometimes if you could maybe develop a community, whatever your niche is, like if it's beauty, maybe there's a beauty products Facebook group or whatever, that, you know, supporting one another that way. And I think a lot of times in groups, people expect to just get supported, but lose sight of the aspect of that supporting one another is just as important as trying to build your own channel. And it's wonderful that I've had the opportunity to bless others through their channel. It's not always about myself. It's about being able to reach other people where they're at as well. So means that I see it as like a conversation, whether it be on YouTube or Facebook or that way. But, and I think that organically helped my channel grow. I think it's wonderful, the support that I've been given. You know, sometimes people message me and say, oh, I'm watching this, or I'm doing this playlist, or I'm doing that. And I appreciate that highly, because not only am I being blessed by kind of the time and the watch time and that kind of thing, but they're being blessed through God's word or even the music. I think sometimes people don't always take a moment just to relax and let their mind go. So that's why I kind of had the relaxation music, whether people use it for studying or sleeping or, you know, meditating on God's word or whatever it might be. It's kind of where it came from with the subscribers. Sorry, went on a little bit of a rabbit trail.
No. It's really great. I really wanted to hear that from you, because I've been interviewing YouTube content creators. And some of them are already 8 years, 5 years, 6 years, but they just had like been serious for 2 years and stuff. They are really struggling with their subscribers. And they wanted also to know this thing that you're sharing. So what I could see here is developing your community is really important, and being part of those groups with regards to your niche. And yeah, with that in mind, Sunshine, you could also invite me on that YouTuber Christian niche also, because I wanted to interview more people from that niche too. You know, okay. if you could invite me on that group, that would really help. See, guys, it's not just me who's helping here, people. It's actually you. The guests are helping me too, in just really building the vision with this channel. So, yeah, I know that this may sound a little bit more technical than right now, but I really want your channel to grow here, Sunshine Rain of Random Channel to grow. So I kind of like would want to share my subscriber count story. I don't know if you have heard it on my previous video, but what I did was, okay, I'll let you see that if you want evidence of what I really did. And you're going to laugh out loud. Here we go. Let's go to my channel. I don't do this often. I'm just going to let you see this.
Okay, that's good.
Right, here's my video. All right, I'm sorry. Oldest. Here we go. So my first ever video here, I was singing a song here, a Christian song. I forgot. All right. And I was singing the song there, and I wanted to share. But anyway, 3 years ago, this was like more of a like just doing experimental. I stopped. All right. Sunshine, I stopped. And 2 years ago, here is it. I will be telling you maybe later on the live how this really happened. This is my first ever video 2 years ago. So sorry for the ads. You're going to have that sooner, I'm telling you. All right. So look at this video. I just shared my devotional for that day is Psalm chapter 1. You know? Blessed is the man that does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, stand in the way of sinners, sit in the seat of mockers, but is delighted in the law of the Lord, and his law is in the day and night, kind of like that. So I just really wanted it to be like the foundation of what I will do. Look at this video, Sunshine. It's portrait. I'm really small there. The background's bad. The lighting is just the bulb out there. As you can see, my face couldn't be seen. I'm just reading my Bible there, and I would say, I'm just going to share this. So yeah, even that's
a perfect
really
example of that. You just, you know, went for it. You
knew
what you wanted to do, and you didn't
look at that. After that, I just had 25 views, 13, 34, 5, you know, and I just kept on going. And then this time here, like my wife will already help me with the lighting and stuff like that. But the point that I'm telling you here is that, so I started that way, and you are doing great for your channel right now. But here's the thing. I really wanted to help you when it comes to growing your channel, and hopefully my story is just merely a suggestion, you know, and you could apply it or not. If it doesn't apply with you, it's just okay. So what I did there, I had that video. I picked 10 of my friends. And I just vision cast to them. All right. You know, because the Bible says without vision, people perish. So my channel is really small. It's really not that great. But I tell them, hey, I'm starting a YouTube channel. Because this is the misconception. Yeah, we're against sub for sub. That's really not bad. That's really bad. We're not doing that. But the misconception sometimes is that when we ask for people to subscribe to our channel, it's kind of like begging from them, especially for our family and friends. Yeah, you know that's really also my mindset there. And but I came to realize, unlike Facebook, unlike Instagram, unlike Twitter, unlike any other social media accounts, for example, Facebook, if you have a page, they just have to like it, and they're going to follow your page. But when it comes to YouTube, I came to realization that they have to, number one, log into their Gmail account, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's key there. Our Indian ringneck parakeet just woke up. Hi, Key. Hi for everybody. Anyway, there's a hand-feed parrot there. Hopefully, he's not going to bite me in the ear. Anyway, yeah. So they have to log into their Gmail account. Second, they have to find your channel name. Third, they have to find the subscribe red button. And then fourth, they have to see where the bell is so that they will be updated with your new videos. So I was like, okay, I think the problem is not with them subscribing, but the problem is that they just don't know how. So I experimented with it. I picked 10 of my friends. I told them, hey man, I'm starting my YouTube channel. I wanted to motivate people every day with the word of God. Here's my video. So I just vision cast on them. If you like it, just log into your Gmail account, hit the subscribe button. I really didn't know about the bell before. That's really one of my errors too. If only I had a bell, maybe more of my subscribers would watch my content. So I thought I was like expecting for them, because they're really real friends. So they are the friends that could tell you straight on your face that you're not really doing well. Stop this, or this is not really awesome. But I had a different feedback. They said, wow, I really didn't know that you could do this in YouTube. So they was like telling, all right, we have a Gmail account. That doesn't even matter. We will be logging in. We will subscribe to your channel. And not just that, we would share this with our friends too. So I was like, okay. So I've realized there that it's not about them not subscribing, but they just don't know how. So here's the thing that I did. I have 5,000 friends on Facebook. All right. But these are not really, like, I don't know everybody. So, because, you know, here in the Philippines, you just have people will just invite you as friend. Then you just have to confirm, and tell to the world that you have 5,000 friends, you know. But for sure, like, maybe 2,000. I really like classmates before, like churchmates and stuff like that too, in the community. So this is what I did. Literally, I messaged all of them. Because you know why? Because I know that what I'm doing, what I'm offering them, is something that they need. For example, for your channel here, most people really need this one. So I messaged them the same thing. And I was expecting for a negative feedback again, but 80% of them really love it. And to make the long story short here, in just 1 month, I gained 1,000 subscribers. Not because, again, of my own strength, like what you're saying. I can tell this with other reviews, because maybe they would say I'm very religious and stuff like that. But yeah, it was really God ordained. And I really thank God, even now. So as you could see, Sasha, like the moment that I've seen this, God is just working out. I said, I want to help other people and just maybe offer a prayer at the end of every channel review just to tell them that. You know, it's God is just doing this. So, yeah, that's the my subscriber count story. So with you here, I'm telling you, I didn't have this great content like you have. I didn't have this great editing that you have. I really didn't have this connections that you have. So you could do it also. So I don't know if that really makes sense with you, or is there anything that you want to comment on that? Yeah, individually. Yeah, individually. I'm telling you, I was saying, I have to do this because they have to hear the message here. That was just in my heart. So individually, hey, Joyce, hey, John, hey, you know. And it seems like a desperate kind of move, but like what I'm telling you, if... No, God loves everybody, and everyone must have an opportunity to hear the word of God. So that's really what motivated me at that time. So, yeah, and All right. Yeah. Because you know what? I just started like saying this, that hi, I'm Pedro Bulianis. Do you know that you have a purpose in this channel? We declare I have a purpose. I just started that like, I don't know, like months ago or a year ago. A year ago. What, my first video? Like 2 years ago? My wife's listening here. Yeah, because my first videos are really just when they click it, straight to the word. This, hey guys, today we're gonna talk about this. I really didn't know that, but yeah, you're doing great. That's also one thing that I was supposed to tell you and to commend you, because I was watching your video here. You giving that, just even that subscribe button, it's what they call call to action. That means a lot. That means a lot, because even though I realize if I will just speak there like, hello guys, my name is Pedro Bulianis. Do you know that you have a purpose? In this channel, we declare I have a purpose. Thank you for all of you subscribed to my YouTube channel. For those who haven't yet subscribed, please click on the subscribe button and hit that notification bell for you to be updated with our new videos. Even though I say that, but I didn't see, give them a picture of the subscribe button, they don't know what to do. So just having the picture there means a lot already. All right, because if I just had this before, I could have like even gained more people. So yeah, and I just really wanted to commend you for your channel, and I will continue with the subscriber count story. So after I reached 1,000 subscribers, there was credits to our family here for you, for your husband, for your kids there, for me, my wife. She supported me really. She's the one who's telling me, why don't you put your camera on landscape mode? Why don't you put your, let's buy a lamp for your lighting, you know? And it was really great. And one time, she has studied social media marketing. Like it's a course for 6 months, I think, or a year. And one time she went home and she told me, 2 months, sorry, 2 months. All right, she's listening here. 2 months. Ah, my bad. I'm not good at the memory stuff. She told me about LinkedIn. All right. Are you familiar with LinkedIn, Sunshine? No. Yeah. That's it. So we have the same reaction. Just, okay, what's LinkedIn? Like, LinkedIn? I know Facebook, I know Twitter, I know Instagram, I have YouTube, but LinkedIn? But yeah, you know, because like the Bible says, love your wife, and I don't want to let her feel bad. So I said, why don't I give it a try? So there you have it. Sometimes, you know, like also the lesson there in my marriage, I started 2 years ago. We were just like 1 year married there, and yeah, listening to her at the time, I really didn't regret it. So what happened was I made a LinkedIn account. So here's the thing with LinkedIn, Sunshine. What happened was I didn't put my real name on it, like my complete name. I just put my channel name on it because they will allow it. So it's simply like making a Facebook page in LinkedIn. All right. So here's the thing. I just tried it. I made a picture of it, like my logo too. And then when they asked for a job, I just put on their YouTuber at YouTube. I really don't know why I did that, because I was like, I don't know, right? I don't know. Could I put in there that I'm like this? So I just put YouTuber at YouTube. And I was amazed, because the moment I put it there, LinkedIn connected me to all YouTube content creators around the world. And I was like, oh, there's something here. All right. So I was like, oh. But I was figuring it out because nobody taught me how to do this. All right. Because, yeah, what's LinkedIn anyway? LinkedIn is a place where people get jobs, people show their businesses. But YouTube, I don't know. Because nobody even told me that. I didn't even see that on the internet and stuff like that. So I put in there, and the thing is with LinkedIn, you could just invite, I think, 40 people to connect with every day. So unlike Facebook, add friend for LinkedIn, just connect with them. So I just tried it. I connected with YouTube content creators. And then I didn't message all of them, right? I didn't message all of them, but I only messaged those people who connected back. So it's kind of like in Facebook, who confirmed your friend request, all right? So this is what, yeah, so this is what I've done there. The same message that I sent my Facebook friend, I sent it to them too. So this is like the thing that I sent. Hey, may this video encourage you today. All right, just that. May this video encourage you today. I put the link of my video there, like for you here, any video that inspired there, like a Bible verse and stuff, I put it there. And then I just put, if you like it, don't forget to subscribe. Then thank you, God bless. Just that. And fast forward, Sunshine, after I think a year now, 20% of my subscribers are from LinkedIn. So I was really surprised. So I was like telling my wife, if I didn't like follow her advice, oh, I could have missed 2,000 subscribers. Yeah, so that's maybe one thing that you could do. And until now, to be honest with you, I'm still doing it. And for this past years, nobody ever commented like, hey, don't share this. Hey, this is bad. No. Most of them will just say thank you. Because, you know, knowing them as like people who are busy and then them watching your video, that would give them fun, entertain them at some point, or inspire them and motivate them. That would really be great. So hopefully, Sunshine, again, these are just but suggestions. But if you want to do it, I know you could crush it also in your YouTube channel. Yeah, there's lots of people there in LinkedIn, so you could really like put it there, like, because they ask for like three skills, I think, or three job descriptions and stuff. You could really put it there and you could connect it them. To be honest, right now I really can't still figure out the way with LinkedIn, with groups and that, but I'm just doing it personally with people. So yeah, that's it. If that applies, so you could just put in there your logo there, Sunshine and Ray of Random, Sunshine Ray of Random name, and that's how they would like, it's really like your branding that would stand out there. So that's the thing with the subscribers. That's just what I could like offer you, and hopefully that could really help you also grow your channel. And yeah, do you have any question? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right. Great question. Before, all right. Later, I will be giving you the link, right? After our live, I will be giving you the link. It's free, and I will give it to you. So many people will ask, why is he not, why is he not sharing it right now? Yeah, I'll just get it to you later. Because, there's different tools for that, like vidIQ, TubeBuddy, but you have to pay for it. So it's really not advisable for like new YouTube content creators who's just starting. Because yeah, I don't really want people to pay first because they're, wow, look at that. She just flown there. Key, what's, anyway. yeah, that's really great there. You could use that too later. I'm just going to give you the link. It's really not that special, but it could, I know it could help you. So let's go back to your videos here. The way you also do your thumbnails are great. Because like the words are really great too. But if you would use Canva, it will really help you a lot with your thumbnails. So Have you ever like tried it, like the Canva stuff already? Not yet. Yeah. So, all right. So here. Yeah. So I'm just gonna go through it just very quick, if it's just okay with you. Oh, sorry. So yeah. Yeah, do you still have time? But if not, we're just gonna end it like I don't. Yeah, because this is the thing with Canva, and I'm gonna teach you how to do it. Actually, it's also my wife who shared this with me, because my thumbnails were really terrible. So just go to Canva, create a design, just put in there YouTube thumbnail. All right, very quick, like in a matter of a minute, you could do this. Just wait another here. So you could, there's a template here. So for example, if you could just like find anything there, for example this one, or really this one, you know. And then maybe if you, for example, you had there some one, all right, you could just put it there, and then you could really just change the template, whatever works for you, that you like see it, you could see it well, you know. And then that's free, right? Just find something that's free. And what's great about it, if you're finding really a specific photo, for example, mountains, there's also free stuff here, so you could just put it there, as I was seeing it on your. Okay, let's make it bigger, because you're doing if I'm doing, okay, your example, you're doing this, and then there's a photo there of the mountains. You could do that, because they would see it, like the whole thing there, that you have someone inspirational stuff. You could really put it there. So yeah, you could do this. I know you could really do this, and you're gonna make great with this. So yeah, and then after that, you could just save it, download it, save it, and then just put it on the thumbnail. So that's really just what it's all about. So most and almost all YouTube content creators use that. So that's really great. And then yeah, your titles, yeah, hopefully that will help you. The titles are really great too, so you don't have to worry about it. And when it comes to the tags and description, just really put whatever you have there in the title. For example, like the Psalm 91 there, just put it also on the description. And also in the tags, you could also put that. So, but literally, your channel is really crushing it for now. 223 subscribers in 2 months. That's really great. Keep up what you're doing. Just edit it really great. And yeah, do you have any still questions? I know you have still a client there. Wow. Yeah, and Sunshine, thank you very much for this. And for the last time, could you invite our viewers, and everybody's going to be watching this video, to sorry, to subscribe to your channel and also follow you in your social media account. All right, so yeah, like what I'm doing always after my channel review here. I really wanted to pray for you and for your channel. Would that be okay? All right, let's do that. So let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this time. I'm so blessed this very day of knowing Sunshine Ray of Random here and the person behind it, like their family. You've been blessing them. You've purpose for them, plans to prosper them, not to harm their plans, to give them a hope and a future. And I pray that they would spread this light. And I know that you have called us to be a light in this world. And Lord, like what you did in my channel, I know that this channel would even do more. Like you said, Lord God, that we could do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And I pray that they could really accomplish the mission, the goal with this. Like everything here are just but temporary, but like as we share your word, share your love to others, it's going to give them hope. It's going to give them like the reason to live. It's going to give them like ways for wherein they could see that life is more than just living the way we do it, but it's really like saying like what Paul says, we have been crucified with Christ. It's no longer us who live, but Christ who lives in us. Lord, we pray. Even right now, I'm really motivated and really blessed by this channel and what they're doing. And I pray for more. And I pray that you would help me also help more of them to succeed in their YouTube channel. Thank you for this time. I pray for blessings for their family. I pray even for their marriage anniversary that's coming up, wedding anniversary that's coming up. Bless them, even for the channel of their kids. We could feature it some other time. And Lord, we thank you for this moment. Holy Spirit, we love you. Jesus, thank you for just loving us in Jesus' name. Amen. So there you have it, guys. It has been a really great time with the Sunshine Ray of Random channel here, and you knowing who's the person behind it, the concept behind it, the heart behind it, the core behind it. So if you are a YouTube content creator and you wanted to be featured next on this segment of my channel, please don't forget to just message me and we will set a schedule for that. So once again, this has been Pedro. And this has been Sunshine Rain of Random Channel. And join us as we declare, I have a purpose.